Hi there, I'm Christopher Harrison. I'm a senior cloud advocate inside of Microsoft Cloud and AI. And what I want to explore here is how we can set up inheritance using templates inside of Django that whenever you're creating really any type of web application, you are going to need some form of consistency throughout all of your different pages, consistent structure, branding, navigation, etc. And obviously, we don't want to have to do the exact same thing in every single HTML file that we create. So fortunately, what we can do in Django is set up inheritance, that we can set up a base page that we can use as our template, and then we can set up children that are then going to use that base, and we can indicate, hey, I want to put some information here, etc. So that way the overall structure stays the same, and then only the spots that need to be updated are then going to be updated. Now, quite frequently, the way that this happens is you'll have a designer that will give you that initial base page, and that's the type of scenario that I'm going to go with here. And then you'll go in and make a couple of modifications to then determine where it is that you want your children pages or your child pages to be able to put in information. So what I have here is a base HTML page, and this has been created by somebody else, created by Anthony Shaw. Thank you, Anthony. And it's already got most everything that I'm going to need, that you're going to notice that it's going to be using a little bit of like bootstrap stuff, and we've got our little links and everything else that's set up. And so I'm going to now use this as the base. Now you may notice as I'm scrolling through this that it's already got a couple of things that aren't actually HTML. And this is where that templating engine that Django provides us is starting to come into action. That what you're going to notice right here is we have this curly percent. This curly percent inside of the Django templating engine indicates that we want to run some function or some other bit of code from the Django framework. And you're going to see this in a few different spots whenever you're working with Django templates. And so the first place where we're seeing this is in this little spot called load static. So load, as you might guess, gives us the ability to load something up. So we're loading up an extension. And in particular, we're loading up this static extension. And this static extension is used in Django to indicate static files. So for example, your CSS files, your images, etc., that all of those are going to be static files. So we don't need to process those at all. Now in Django, you can actually change where that directory is going to be. And there's also a little bit of special magic that needs to happen in order for Django to properly serve up static files. And so that's why we have this load static to load that extension up. And then what you're going to notice is that anytime that we want to go refer to something that's inside of our static folder, then what we're going to do is we're going to again use that curly percent, say static, and then whatever the name of the file is. So this is now going to load up from our CSS folder, theme.css. And then you'll notice right here that we've got another call to static. This is going to go load up the small logo.png file from the image, well, res image folder, and so forth. So you can start to see how that goes. So anything inside of that static that we want to bring in, that's how we're going to do it. Now we're actually going to do something sort of similar to create inside of this base page here. This is going to be our parent or our base page. We're going to create different blocks. And so our blocks are going to be where the child pages are going to be allowed to put in information. Now we'll add these in and we'll give them names. And I'm going to use again that Django extension. I'm going to type out block. It will give me a little bit of a snippet here. So I'm just going to hit tab with that selected. And I'm going to give this a name of title, just like that. And now let me go ahead and move that down. And I'm just going to put in that default content of that Rel Cloud Expand Your Horizons. So our block, end block, this is now where a child page will be able to put in information. And there is our default. One little thing that's worth noting is that having the name on the end block is optional, but it can help potentially make your page a little bit more readable, especially if your blocks start to get a bit larger. So this is now going to be somewhere where a child page will be able to put in its own information. So that's our title. Let's go ahead and do the same for the content down below. So let's, again, block just like that. Hit tab. Let's call this content. There we go. And let's go ahead and move that default up inside of there. Okay. So now what we've done is we've now created this base page. Now I want to go use this. So let me go back to the couple of pages that we created earlier. So I've got my index and my about. The way that we're going to indicate that base page is up at the very top is we say extends. Again, I'll use a snippet here. So extends and then base.html. And so now I'll be able to say, hey, I want to put certain information into particular blocks. And so the first one is going to be the title. The next one is going to be the content. And so now I can go ahead and move all of that information that we had before into those little spots. So now let me go ahead and just clean up the rest of the HTML. And now this will use that. So it's going to put our Rel Cloud title into the title. Oops, let's make sure I put that into the right location. That's probably going to help. There we go. That looks a little bit better. So it's going to put the title in and it's going to put the content in. And I can do that exact same thing to my about page. So again, let's just sneak up here, extends base.html block and our title block and our content. And now let's move things in. Boop. And boop, sound effects help. There we go. Cool. And let's just get rid of the rest on the bottom. So now what we're going to notice is that instead of that kind of plain HTML is instead we're going to, if I bring up my page and hit refresh, we're now going to get that really nice layout. Let me zoom out here to make this look a little bit better. There we go. About like that. And so now there is our about content. So that's the about. And you'll notice that we're going to that about page. And then our title says about Rel Cloud. And if I get rid of that about, we'll just go to the default page. It just says Rel Cloud. And then there is the information from our index being injected in. Now, one last little thing that I want to highlight here about our templates is you are going to notice that we want to be able to link this back to the home page and this to the about page. Now, we could go in and hard code URLs, but remember that our URLs inside of Django are going to be identified by the routes. So we don't want to do it that way. Instead, what we want to do is we want to use the URL function, the URL directive, to indicate what URL we want in place. So I'm going to call this about. So you'll notice that I'm updating the about link. I'm setting the href to now be this URL about. Now that name is going to be pulled out of the URL's py file that we specified a name there. So it will be able to pull it out of there. And I'm going to do the exact same thing up here with the home button. Let's go in and again, URL. Again, I'm taking advantage of the snippets that are built in. Index, hit save. And now if I come back to my page, a real quick refresh, And now if I click About, this takes me to my About page. We can see our About right here. And then if I hit the little Home, that will then take us home. So what we saw here is how we can set up a base page to inherit from, how we can set up child pages to use that base, how we can utilize those blocks to determine where it is that people are allowed to put in different pieces of information. And we also saw two big directives on how we can look up static locations and how we can find URL paths from our routing table.